Let me respond to a quick comment here. Mustafa speaks. I believe he's a young Muslim apologist. But notice that when we get corrected, it's the Muslim who needs correcting. Mustafa speaks, corrects us, completely destroys our argument. It says, nowhere in those verses does it mention anything about a language. If you notice, it's speaking about a nation, hence the Gentiles, the Ishmaelites in particular, not a language. So according to Mustafa speaks, nowhere in those verses does it mention a language. Okay, let's just read Surah 14, verse 4, one more time. Matter of fact, I'll give you as many translations as you want, Mustafa.
Let me put it on the screen. You said 14?
Yep. No, 4. 4. 4. Yeah, chapter 14, verse 4.
Verse 4, okay.
Okay. So let's see what the Clear Quran and Sahih International say. We have not sent a messenger except in the language of his people to clarify the message for them. All right. So looks like it says language.
For them. Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe it's a mistranslation because Mustafa speaks says the Quran nowhere mentions the language. So let's Sahih International there. And we did not send any messenger except speaking in the what? Language. No, Mustafa speaks says the word language isn't in this. So in the language of his people to state clearly for them. Let me read a few more. Pickthall. And we never sent a messenger save with the language of his folk that he might make the message clear for them. Yusuf Ali. We sent not an apostle except to teach in the language of his own people in order to make things clear for them.
Here is the Arabic too. Like it's direct. It's here on the screen. Lisan, language. It's right here.
The language. With the language.
Yeah.
And we sent Hilali Khan, and we sent not a messenger except with the language of his people in order that he might make the message clear for them. Here's what's amazing. Look, let me shook here. And we did not send any apostle, but with the language of his people so that he might explain it to them clearly. Over and over again, Allah says this. Now, notice, Mustafa speaks. This is as clear as anything in the Quran ever is. It doesn't get any clearer than this in the perfectly clear Quran. Allah says, I only send a messenger in the language of the people he's sent to so that they can understand it in their language. He says that, and you have to deny it and say, he never says that. He never says what he clearly and obviously says. You have to say he never says that. Why? Because on some level, you understand how ridiculous this is. You understand, wait a minute, it makes no sense for Muhammad to be the prophet sent to German speakers and English speakers and French speakers and Italian speakers. It makes no sense for Muhammad to be sent to all of them in these other languages if Allah says that he only sends a messenger to the people in their language. You understand that. And so you had to just like mentally block out what this verse is saying. And yet, guess what? That is what Allah said. It is what Allah said, which means you have to know at this point. You have to know that the Quran is completely incoherent. So, dude, if you're
and look at this verse here. Let's look at this one too. This is very significant. I don't know if this person missed this Quran verse, but we just read this as well, which says, "And thus we have revealed to you an Arabic Quran."
Arabic Quran, language.
Arabic
right?
Quran. We have revealed to you, thus we have revealed to you an Arabic Quran that you may warn the mother of cities, Mecca, and those around it. So therefore, we have revealed to you an Arabic Quran in Arabic so that you may warn Mecca and the people around it. People around it and in Mecca who speak Arabic. That is why we have sent it to you in Arabic, so that you may warn those people in there and around. How much more clear could we possibly make it?
Yeah, and yet, ladies and gentlemen, every single Muslim apologist you run into will tell you the Quran is the final book and everyone now needs to get all of their information about the Almighty and how they're supposed to live from the Arabic Quran, even if they don't understand it and even if they don't speak Arabic. This is just the position that Allah has left you in, even though it's exactly what Allah says he didn't want to do to you. But once again, Allah's message is, guys, under no circumstances do I want you to be in a position where you have to rely on someone else who speaks some other language to tell you what to believe about God. I do not want you to, I do not want you to ever be in that situation, or the situation where in order to know what God is telling you, you have to say, okay, I'm just going to go out and spend years of my life learning this other language so that I can understand it. So that then after I've done all this, all these years of research, I can finally understand what God is telling me to do. In order to avoid people being in that situation, Allah sends the Quran revealed to speakers of Arabic so that they have a revelation that they can understand in their language. And what does every Muslim in the world tell you about Islam? The exact opposite. Here's the book for all people who don't speak the language. There's amazing stuff, man. Again, if I didn't know anything else about Islam, so if I didn't know about Muhammad having sex with Aisha, you know, the prepubescent girls, Muhammad taking the wife of his own adopted son, if I didn't know about the sex slaves, if I didn't know about any of this stuff, if I just knew this about Islam, I would say, this is ridiculous. This is ridiculous nonsense that he's claiming that he revealed the book in this language because you can't know, you can't be expected to trust translations and so on. This is completely ridiculous if he says he's trying to avoid this and now everyone is expected, everyone except Arab, native Arabic speakers. And even then it doesn't work because native Arabic is not the exact same thing as classical Arabic. So the only people to whom, so the vast majority of the world's population, the Quran is never going to be clear to. And and yet Allah says that he's sending this because everyone needs a clear revelation that they can understand. Yeah. You're basically, so we know that according to what Muslims are telling us, Allah is the worst communicator in the world. And he's completely incompetent when it comes to responding to basic objections. The Quran is one giant catastrophe. Allah is trying to tell people, I'm trying desperately to give you a revelation in your own language because that's the only way you can know what to do. And yet I've just failed miserably. I've failed completely. I'm a complete failure. I never get anything I want. Everyone corrupts the message. And then the only revelation I've actually preserved somehow says that all the other revelations have been preserved and tells people to judge by those. And I just can't, gosh, will some apologists please come and rescue me because I can't do this on my own.
That's
the message from Islam. Allah screwed up massively, and now he needs the Shabir Ali's and Adnan Rashid's and all these guys of the world to come and rescue, to come clean up this massive, epic dumpster fire of a train wreck that he has created.
Yep.
They have to clean up the mess that he made.